the capital city of Finland. It borders the town of Myrskylä. This is Lasse Virran and his wife Päivi. They were both born in Myrskylä. They were married a few months before the 1976 Montreal Olympic Games, and they live here with their son Tomas. Lasse Virran is a policeman by profession. He is not famous for his police work. Lasse Virran is known as the greatest distance runner in modern Olympic history.
My life really changes. Normally in the morning I jog before breakfast. My police work is the usual routine, investigating accidents, robberies. After work, I come home and have dinner. Then, later on in the evening, I go jogging again. The schedule only changes when I have to work in the evening.
This is Rolf Haikola. He lives in Lasse Virran's hometown of Myrskylä. Rolf Haikola is also Lasse Virran's coach.
In the 1920s and the 1930s, Finland had the greatest long-distance runners in the world. In the 1924 and 1928 Olympic Games, runners like Paavo Nurmi and Willy Ritola helped us win almost every event from the 1500 meters to the marathon, including the 3000 meter steeplechase. When I began coaching, I would seek out Paavo Nurmi's advice. He gave me a lot of his knowledge. It is interesting, he would talk to me, but not to my runners. He was very shy, and he always said, "Why would your runners want to talk to me? They don't even know me."
Berlin, 1936, the 11th Olympiad of the modern Olympic era. Finnish long-distance runners are expected to continue their dominance of the long-distance events. August 2, 1936, the final of the 10,000 meters, a race that had been contested five times in Olympic competition. Four of the five gold medals were won by Finns, men who made up the honor roll of champions who became known to the world as the Flying Finns. The legendary Hannes Kolomainen, who won the first Olympic 10,000 meters ever run at the Stockholm Games of 1912. Willy Ritola, the 1924 Paris gold medal winner, and the incomparable Paavo Nurmi, who won the gold medal at the 1920 Antwerp Olympics and again in Amsterdam in 1928. Now here in Berlin, three Finnish runners, Jalmari Salminen, Arvo Askala, and Volmari Isoholo, intend to make up for the only Finnish defeat in the Olympic 10,000 meters, which occurred 4 years before at the Los Angeles Games, when Janusz Kuzorzynski of Poland won the gold medal, with Finnish runners coming in second and third. Down the home stretch, Salminen leads his teammate Oskala past a lap runner to the finish line. 20 meters back in third place, Isoholo of Finland. Here in Berlin, Finnish runners stand on all three steps of the Olympic 10,000 meter victory platform.
Our runners also won gold medals in the 5,000 meters and 3,000 meter steeplechase. But the Berlin Games of 1936 ended Finnish domination of long distance events. In the next six Olympiads, 36 years, Finnish runners did not win a single gold medal. The world had passed us by. It was necessary to go outside Finland for help. We turned to Arthur Lydiard of New Zealand.
Arthur Lydiard coached the incomparable New Zealand 800 and 1500 meter Olympic champion Peter Snell. His training methods were controversial. Lydiard believed that victory at every distance could be achieved by gaining strength and endurance while training for the marathon. Lydiard's belief was that the mental preparation, courage and stamina needed to run the 26-mile, 385-yard marathon were the cornerstones for running in all events. To the Finns, Lydiard's methods were part of their own national tradition.
Well, the best psychology you can use on anyone is to teach them why they're doing something. It's a question of motivation and an intelligent approach to training. And the Finns are very tenacious and nationalistic. Lasse Wierin is a very special person. He doesn't care what other people think about him. He knows exactly what he's going to do, and he's capable of doing it.
For Lasse Wierin, the first opportunity will come in the fall of 1972 in Munich, the 20th renewal of the modern Olympic Games.